Israeli tanks pushing deeper into central Gaza. Israel sharply escalated its ground war this week, forcing tens of thousands of already displaced Palestinians to flee in a new exodus. The focus of the fighting is now in central areas, but airstrikes continue to pound southern Gaza. In Rafah, an Israeli strike killed at least 20 people and left dozens more injured. The Palestinian death toll in the war has risen to around 21,300. Nearly 1% of Gaza's population. The human rights situation in the occupied West Bank facing a rapid deterioration. That's according to a United Nations report saying 300 Palestinians there had been killed since the Israel-Hamas war erupted last August 7. Most of the killings were a result of Israel's offensive, while some were due to Jewish settler attacks.
The use of military tactics and weapons in law enforcement contexts and the use of unnecessary or disproportionate force by the Israeli security forces are extremely troubling. I call on Israel to take immediate, clear and effective steps to put an end to settler violence against the Palestinian population, to investigate all incidents of violence by settlers and Israeli security forces.
UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres calls for a year of rebuilding trust and hope in 2024. In his New Year message, Guterres urged world leaders to work together in bringing peace to countries ruined by conflicts. He also called on the world to unite in addressing climate change and poverty.
2023 has been a year of enormous suffering, violence, and climate chaos. Humanity is in pain. Our planet is in peril. 2023 is the hottest year on record. People are getting crushed by growing poverty and hunger. Wars are growing in number and ferocity, and trust is in short supply. But pointing fingers and pointing guns lead nowhere. Humanity is strongest when we stand together. The United Nations will keep rallying the world for peace, sustainable development, and human rights. Let us resolve to make 2024 a year of building trust and hope in all that we can accomplish together.
Over now to the maritime row between the Philippines and China. Beijing says it will not turn a blind eye to what it called repeated provocations and harassment by the Philippines. China's defense ministry insists actions taken by its Coast Guard were unnecessary, justified, and legitimate. It also called Manila's statements on their maritime encounters purely false hype. Earlier this month, China fired water cannons on Philippine vessels in two separate incidents, causing damage to resupply boats. The two sides have been blaming each other over escalating tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Top Philippine and U.S. diplomats discuss Manila's long-standing maritime row with Beijing. Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo spoke on the phone with U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken. Blinken reaffirmed Washington's ironclad commitment to Manila under the Mutual Defense Treaty. Their phone conversation follows a warning from China for the U.S. to stop meddling in South China Sea issues. Now, South Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol calls for an immediate retaliation for any provocations from North Korea. Yoon visited a frontline military unit Thursday after North Korean leader Kim Jong-un ordered his government to speed up war preparations, including boosting Pyongyang's nuclear program. Kim claimed his order is meant to counter what he called unprecedented confrontational moves by the U.S. Meanwhile, Yoon told troops in Yeonchon to crush threats on the spot. He was also briefed on the preparedness of South Korea's military. Over in Budapest, the River Danube unexpectedly bursts its banks with water levels reaching a decade high of 6.93 meters. The last time Danube's level exceeded 6 meters in December dates back to 1987, but it did not flood the embankment roads. The community meanwhile actively responded as workers built ramps and deployed mobile dams. While not causing major damage, experts warn of more frequent floods due to climate change. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with tragic news out of San Diego, California, where the bodies of parents Melissa Domingo Soto and Johnny Richard Soto have been found lifeless. The 45-year-old Hispanic Filipina and her 52-year-old Hispanic husband disappeared from their San Diego house on the night of December 20, according to their adult children. The couple had reportedly separated in July after 20 years of marriage. On Tuesday, the U.S. Customs and Border Patrol found a vehicle associated with the missing couple at the Golden Acre Casino parking lot where their bodies were found. Police are investigating the tragedy as a murder-suicide, saying Johnny suffered from a self-inflicted gunshot wound to the head while Melissa died of undetermined injuries. In sports, a pair of Filipino-American college football stars will be leaving their high-profile colleges to link up in sunny Southern California. San Diego State University has announced that they have signed quarterback A.J. Duffy, who played sparingly at Florida State University in the past two seasons. Joining the Phil-Am quarterback will be a Phil-Am pass catcher. Tight end Mikey Harrison has announced that he is verbally committed to attend San Diego State University next season. The San Francisco native played last year at the University of Colorado under Coach Deion Sanders. In his two seasons in Colorado, Harrison caught five touchdowns, including a game-winning touchdown catch against Colorado State University.
Life without you is just like chocolate chip cookies without chocolate chips. It's just flour.
In entertainment news, Tubby Nugget has amassed over 2.5 million Instagram followers with its cute, wholesome short cartoons.
You're listening to Tubby Toons, where we deliver positive vibes all day, all the time.
The brown nugget-shaped characters are the brainchild of Filipino-American Janine Pastores and her husband, Joshua Drew Jackson.
That's the inside joke because I used to call him Nugget all the time.
Yeah, so we draw her little nuggets on my clothing and just send it to her whenever she was feeling like sad or like down, just cheer her up.
What was meant to be a fun break from the pressures of the entertainment industry where the husband and wife team work has now grown into a cartoon line with plush dolls, stickers, and appearances at comic book and pop culture conventions.
Our character is all about like self-love and making sure that you're taking care of your mental health, but also embracing your inner child. And it's a lot. Like our personal sense of humor, we want people to feel like the internet is a safe place to express yourself.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.